Like to introduce my sincere thanks to the conference committee and conference management to invite me to this important conference and to give me a chance to deliver at this important conference. After a long communication traffic, about 10 months, we are here. And I am delivering my talk at this important conference. Let me inform you that this is a multidisciplinary conference, and I am sure you agree with me that every scientist is not familiar with every subject of the science. Therefore, at the beginning of my talk, I will introduce the basic terms and definitions related to the Shapley-Pomery effect and superelasticity. After that, I will introduce the experimental result carried out on the two Kapper-Bay Shapley-Pomery alloys. The title of my presentation is Crystallographic Basis of Thermal and Mechanical Memory in Shapley-Pomery alloys. Shapley-Pomery alloys are thermoresponsive materials and exhibit a peculiar property called Shapley-Pomery effect. This behavior is initiated by cooling and deformation processes and perform thermally on heating and cooling in the bath level, and this behavior can be called thermal memory or thermoelasticity. These alloys can be plastic deformed in low temperature condition and record the original shape. Just thermal means on heating over the reverse austenitic transformation temperature after removing the strain. And shape of this material cycle between deformed and original shapes on cooling and heating in the bulk level, following first cooling and deformation processes. These alloys exhibit another property called superelasticity, which is performed by mechanical stresses in a constant temperature, and this behavior can be called mechanical memory. This is main processes for thermal memory or Shapley-Pomery effect. As I mentioned, Shapley-Pomery effect is initiated on cooling and deformation and performed thermally on heating and cooling after first cooling and deformation processes. On cooling, shape of the material doesn't change, but crystallographic transformations occur in the atomic level. Second step is deformation. This deformation is a plastic deformation and keeps the deformed shape after releasing. After that, on heating, deformed shape of the material turns into the original parenthesis shape. On heating, and shape of the material cycle between deformed and original shapes on cooling and heating in the reversible way. Shapley-Pomery effect and superelasticity is result of the crystallographic transformations, thermal and stress-induced multistate transformations, and evaluated by the structural change in atomic decay. Shapley-Pomery effect is performed thermally in a temperature interval depending on the forward austenitic martensite and reverse martensite austenitic transformation on cooling and heating. Superelasticity is performed in the parent austenitic phase aging just above the austenitic finish temperature. For the superelasticity, materials are stressed in the parent phase aging and shape recovery is performed instant and simultaneously upon releasing the applied stress. This is the temperature hysteresis of Shapley-Pomery alloys. thermal induced magnetic transformations occur on cooling and transformations start at MS temperature and completed at MF temperature. After that, on heating, reverse osmotic transformations start at AS temperature and completed at AF temperatures. MS is martensit start and MS is martensit finish temperatures. These are the stress strain characteristics in shape memory effect and superelasticity. In the shape memory effect, the materials are deformed in the low temperature condition and stress-induced martensitic transformations occurs at the plateau level. As you can see, early stage of deformation exhibits elastic material behavior. Also, as you can see, stressing and releasing paths are different in the superelasticity, and this cycle represents the energy dissipation. This is another stress-strain diagram between martensit finish and austenite start temperature, and as you can see, stress-strain profile exhibits different characteristics based on shape memory effect and superelasticity. This is the complete illustration of shape memory effect and superelasticity. It is important that low temperature phase of the materials can be called soft phase, and with the deformation in the low temperature state, materials keeps the deformed shape after releasing due to the plastic deformation, and on heating recover the original shape by means of reverse osmotic transformation. After that, shape of the material cycle between deformed and original shapes on cooling and heating. In the superelasticity, materials are stressed in the parent phase raising, and upon releasing, you recover the original shape by representing elastic material behavior. After that, on cooling, with the deformation material recovered, turn into the deformed shape, and by releasing, recover the original shape. Shape memory behavior is evaluated by the microstructural change in atomic scale or angstrom level caused by the internal stresses, and shape change occurs in the bulk level. Martensitic transformations occur in the material in thermal manner on cooling from high temperature parent phase raging, and it is characterized by the changes in the crystal structure of material. These transformations are lattice distorting fast transformations and occur as twin martensites with the cooperative movement of atoms over very short distances on the order of by means of shell-like mechanism. Twin martensitic structures turn into the detwin martensitic structure or reoriented martensitic structures by means of stress-strain-induced martensitic transformation applying external stress. This is the schematic of shape memory cycle in the crystallographic level. Let me inform you that shape memory effect and superelasticity is observed in the beta phase regime of the materials, and ordered phase structure is essential. In the shape memory, effect, first step is cooling, and on cooling, ordered parent phase structure turn into the detwin martensitic structures by means of thermal induced martensitic transformation. After that, with the deformation, twin martensitic structures turn into the detwin martensitic structures by means of stress-induced martensitic transformation. And upon heating, after these processes, detwin martensitic structures turn into the ordered parenthesis stresses by means of reverse austenitic transformation and crystal structure of material cycle between detuned martensitic stresses and ordered parenthesis stresses on cooling and heating. It is important that detuned martensitic stresses occurs mechanically by the mechanical stressing in the first step, but this in this cycle, thermal cycle, stress-induced martensitic transformation occurs thermally on heating. This is also schematic of superelasticity. In the superelasticity, materials are stressed in elasticity limit in the parenthesis region and ordered parenthesis structures turn into the detuned martensitic structures by means of stress-induced martensitic transformation. Yet with the relation, detuned structures turn into the ordered parenthesis structures by means of reverse austenitic transformation. It is important that this cycle occurs thermally, stressing and releasing in the superelasticity, but in the shape memory effect, this cycle occurs thermally on cooling and heating. I mentioned superelasticity is also linked with stress-induced martensitic transformation, which is induced by applying mechanical stress. And with the stress, parent austenitic phase structures turn into the completely detuned martensitic structures, as in the deformation step of shape memory effect, and detuned martensitic structures turn into the parent phase structure upon releasing, as I mentioned, and the diffractorum. The crystal structures of material cycles between the parenthesis structures and detuned martensitic structures on stressing and releasing. It is important that stress strain curve exhibits nonlinear behavior and stressing and releasing paths are different and hysteresis loops refers to the energy dissipation. This is the stressing and releasing path in the superelasticity. With the stressing, ordered parenthesis structures turn into the detuned martensitic structures by means of stress-induced martensitic transformation. Also, you can see that this hysteresis is not linear, and this lobes refers to the energy dissipation. Martensitic transformations are first order solid state fast transitions and occur in a fifth step with the cooperative movement of atoms in displacement manner. Therefore, these transitions have diffusion character and product martensitic phase inherits the order of parent austenitic phase. These transformations mainly occur into basic steps, being distortion and lattice invariant shape. These are the basic beta phase structures observed in the beta phase region of the material. First figure represent the ordinary body-centered cubic structures. Second figure represent the cesium chloride type superlattice structures. Third figure represent the deuterate type crystal structure, which is observed in the ternary Kapur's bell shape Momer alloys and other alloys. And last big figure also represent the L2-1 type ordered phase structures. Bain distortion is mainly effective in ternary Kapur's bell shape Momer alloys and consists of an expansion of 26% in 1-1 type axis called Bain axis and a compression of 11% in the 1-1 type direction perpendicular to the Bain axis. There are three Bain axes, these are cube axes, 100, 010, 001A, and BCC-based unit cell turn into the body central Bodhisattva tetragonal structures as trivayan in different orientations. That these invariantials occur as martensit variants on one monotype planes of alternate matrix, and dashes occur in two opposite directions, one monotype direction on the one monotype planes. One monoplane family represents six certain planes and totally 24 martensit variants occurs. These planes are 1-1-0, -1-1-0, 1-0-1, -0-1, 0-1-1, and 0-1-1. Lattice invariantial and lattice twinning is not uniform in Kapri shape Omer alloys and dashes house to the formation of Lattice structures. 1-1-0 type planes of parenthesis turn into the unusual layer structures, which consists of an array of closed packets with complicated stacking sequences called as 3R, 9R, or 18R martensit size, depending on the stacking sequences on the closed packet planes of the ordered lattice. The periodicity and therefore the unit cell is completed through 18 layers in directions that in case of 18R martensit structures. This is the formation of layer structures in the meta B2 type super lattice structures. This is the stacking of the 1-1-0 type planes. Stackings are AB, AB, AB with these planes. And with the lattice invariantials, these stackings turn into the layer structures with these stackings ABC, BCA, CAB, and A4, 18R martensitic structures. This is another illustration of the formation of layer structure for DO3 type ordered parenthesis structures and 18R martensitic structures. These are the basic key terms and definitions related to the shape memory effect and super elasticity. As I mentioned, experimental studies were performed to copper base shape memory alloys. These are copper zinc aluminum and copper aluminum mangan alloys. And you can see the alloy compositions. And these compositions were selected in the beta phase regime of the material. As you can see, martensit start and martensit finish temperatures are over the room temperature, and both of the alloy samples are complete the martensitic state at the room temperature. Specimens obtained from these alloys were solution treated for homogenization in the beta phase field as following then quenched in ice brain and aged at room temperature. These temperatures are 830 and 700 degrees for copper zinc aluminum and copper aluminum mangan alloys. And these temperatures were selected in the beta phase region of the materials. Powder specimens for X-ray examinations were prepared by filling the alloys, and these specimens were sealed in evacuated quartz tubes and given the beta phase homogenization treatment in order to release the strain effect and protect the formation intermediate phases. These temperatures are also the same, and homogenization time were selected 15 minutes for both of the alloy samples. Powder diffractorums were obtained for all the specimens at the aging stage of the material at the room temperatures. This is an X-ray diffractorum taken from copper zinc aluminum alloy samples after Long term aging at room temperature for about 15 years after quenching. As you can see, peak intensities and peak characteristics are different, and this diffractorum exhibits superlattice reflection. Let me inform you that these plane pairs are important for the ternary capillary bell shaped mammary alveoli. These are 122, 202, 128, 208, 1210, 2010, and others. This is another X-ray diffractorum taken from a copper aluminum mangan alloy samples after long-term aging at room temperature about 15 years after quenching. As you can see, this diffractorum also exhibits the same characters with this plane pairs. A series of X-ray diffractorums have been taken from both of the alloy samples in a long time interval, and some change have been observed in the diffraction angles, peak intensities, and peak characteristic with age and duration. In particular, some of the successive peak space have shifted toward each other, and these successive peaks provide the following relation between Miller indices for 18-hour Martensitic structures in the ternary capillary bell shaped mammary alveoli. This plane pairs can be listed as follow, as I mentioned on the diffractorum. 122, 202, 128, 208, 1210, 2010, 040, 320, and others. At the long-term investigation, it is observed that this peak pair come close each other with age and duration, and this change refers to the changes in the crystal structure of material. Also, this change refers to the rearrangement of atom in disordered manner in the martensitic state. The basal plane of martensite is subjected to the hexagonal distortion with martensit formation, on which atom size have important effect. In case the atoms occupying the lattice sites have the same size, the basal plane of martensite becomes regular hexagon. Otherwise, deviations occur from the hexagonal arrangement of the atoms in case of atom size are different. In the disordered case, all of the lattice sites are occupied randomly, and atomic sizes can be taken approximately equal each other. In the disordered, in the ordered case, lattice sites are occupied regularly by certain atoms which have different atomic sizes, and basal plane deviates from the regular hexagonal arrangement of atoms due to the atomic size differences. This is the basal plane of martensite in the parent phase. This is rectangular shape. This rectangular shape turned into the hexagonal shape with the martensitic transformation. As I mentioned, in the disordered case, we don't know which atom occupies which atom sizes, and we can take atomic sizes equal each other, and hexagon becomes regular hexagon. In the ordered case, atomic distribution is regularly, and neighbor atoms are not in the same size, but deviations occurs from the regular hexagonal arrangement of the atoms. Second experimental study were performed in the electron microscope, thermal transmission electron microscope, and taken electron diffraction patterns and image of the surface of the interface of the martensite. As you can see, electron diffraction patterns also exhibit superlattice reflection. Conclusion, shape memory effect is evaluated by the structural change in atomic scale by means of martensitic transformation. The fundamental structures of the beta type martensites are orthorhombic closed packet structures which consist of an array of closed packet planes in coupled wave shape memory alloys. The beta type martensites have the layered structures and are characterized by the stacking sequences depending on the order in the parent wave region. Coupled wave ternary alloys have the deuteritized superlattice structure in the parent austenite wave region, and the following stacking sequences occur with the martensitic transformation. These sequences are AB, CB, CA, CA, BA, BC, BC, AC, and AB for 18R martensitic structures. On the basis of austenite martensitic relation, the basal plane of 9R or 18R martensites originates from the 1-1 type planes of parent phase, on which lattice invariances occurs into opposite direction with the martensitic transformation. These are the references. And thank you very much for your attention.